Good evening and welcome. My name is Mary Gadd and I am the extremely proud principal of Cheshire High School. Dr. Solon, Mr. Perugini, members of the Board of Education, members of the administration, parents, relatives, friends, members of the staff and faculty at Cheshire High School, on behalf of Mrs. Pels, Dr. Reed, Mr. Tartarelli, Mr. Trafone, and Mrs. Broadway, we welcome you to the 69th annual commencement, the graduation. Please stand and join us in honoring America as members of the CHS Honors Choir sing our national anthem. Thank you. What a lovely job. Thank you, Honors Choir. It is my pleasure now to introduce to you the president of the class of 2023, Asya Terabar.
Good evening, Cheshire High School students, staff, friends, and family. As we gather here today to celebrate this significant milestone together, I find myself reflecting on our time together in high school and how we've changed from our naive six-year-old selves entering first grade. We've grown taller, matured, and gained knowledge from our experiences in life and our 12 years of education. I know I've changed a lot too, but one thing that hasn't changed about me is my inability to stay organized. If you were to enter my room on any given day, you'd be greeted by a sight that some might describe as messy, cluttered, or maybe even just gross. Piles of disorganized papers litter the floor, and books, souvenirs, and miscellaneous toys sit haphazardly in my bookshelf as clothing overflows from my closet. Often my floor becomes an obstacle course, challenging my motor skills at 6:30 every morning to avoid crushing my laptop or tripping on a cable. To the untrained eye, or from the perspective of my parents, my room is just a biohazard, polluted enough to get a ticket from the EPA. For my parents, and I'm assuming many of the parents in the audience, a high schooler's room is one of the filthiest, most dreaded environments on earth. Despite my parents begging, though, I refuse to get rid of any of my supposed junk. My collection of things and whatchamacallits each tell their own stories, their own memories, and they tell of the people of the life who have shaped me into the person standing before you today. A stack of expired breakfast vouchers for a random hotel in Anchorage, Alaska sits in my cabinet, untouched after years. The worn down edges and creases in the paper tell of tales trying to eat two free breakfasts in the same morning, quickly regretting that decision, and the many adventures spent that week with my mom, my dad, and my brother. Stretched out hair ties and knee-high socks ridden with holes hide in the depths of my closet, reminding me of times with teammates, celebrating wins over ice cream at Sweet Claude's, and coming closer through hugs over losses. A little stuffed animal of an orangutan and a tiny broken clock act as treasures found on numerous adventures spent with friends roaming IKEA and eating tacos at Long Wharf with no goal other than to spend time with each other. Amidst the apparent chaos, there's this underlying beauty, a beauty that lies in the very human tendency to be sentimental about objects. These possessions of ours, seemingly mundane, transform into vessels of significance when intertwined with memories we care about, with the people we care about. To my peers, consider the items you have amassed over the years, collecting dust in the treacherous corners of your room, and yet with every parent-sponsored clean, you refuse to throw them out. Think of the worn and tattered stuffed animals, or maybe the baby blankets, the rips and the scuffs, carrying memories of laughter, wrestling, and snuggling between you and perhaps a sibling, childhood friend, or a family member. Think of school-sanctioned shirts from elementary school worn during intense and emotionally charged rounds of tug-of-war during field day, or even those team badges we wore to DC in eighth grade, representing a time of growth spurts, way too much Axe body spray, and cringy TikTok dances that we all shared together. Our little collectibles serve as a mechanism to relive and remember our shared emotions and experiences. And this concept applies to the reminders of our academic experience, our old notes, homework assignments, textbooks you forgot to return, but it's too late now. Even the graduation cap and gowns you are wearing now are infused with the memories of the people who have shaped our education. They are not merely physical artifacts, they embody the lessons learned, the bonds forged, and the personal growth that characterizes the high school experience. They remind us both of the surface level knowledge we've learned from constructing an annotated bibliography to calculating the range of a projectile, and the more meaningful discoveries and realizations we have made in our time here that will follow us wherever we choose to go. We attach sentiment to these objects because they carry within them the imprints of the moments spent with loved ones. They become a tangible representation of experiences, emotions, and connections we have formed. They represent the influence of others on ourselves and how the people around us carve our blank slates into the people that we become. It is through these objects that we can revisit cherished memories, even long after the people who have made them have moved on from our lives. And so, as we stand on this precipice of this new chapter in our lives, let us remember the importance of the relationships we have cultivated. Let us cherish the connections that have transformed ordinary objects into cherished valuables. As we move forward into the world, let us not be consumed by external, more quantitative measures of success, but instead focus on the people and the relationships that bring depth and meaning to our lives. Let us take a moment to express our gratitude to those that lie in the memories we treasure, to our parents, guardians, and family members who have supported us unconditionally, to our teachers, community leaders, and role models who have imparted knowledge and wisdom, and to our friends who have stood by us through laughter and tears. Thank you for being the life force behind the silly little objects that we hold dear. Class of 2023, today we celebrate not only our individual achievements, but also the network of love and camaraderie that has carried through our academic and personal journeys. Let us embrace the messiness of life, the random objects and the sentimental artifacts, knowing that they are reminders of the incredible people who have graced our lives. So hold on to that collection of junk you have now, but make room for some new additions. As we enter this next chapter, embrace new connections and people in your life, and remember to hold on to the old ones as well. Thank you.
It is my pleasure to introduce to you Assistant Principal Kristen Pels to recognize those students entering the military following graduation.
Good evening. At this time, I am proud to recognize the Cheshire High School graduates who have made a commitment to their country by joining the armed forces. The following students should please rise and remain standing to be recognized. Gianna Esposito will be joining the Army. Vincent Lynn has enlisted in the Marines. Autumn Mitchell will join the Air Force. Haley Shaw will be attending West Point. Woo! and Legina Triano has enlisted in the National Guard. Thank you for your service.
It is now my honor to present to you Clyde D'Souza, the salutatorian for the Cheshire High School Class of 2023. I ask Clyde's parents to rise and be recognized. Clyde, congratulations.
Students, teachers, family, and faculty, it is my pleasure to address you all on this lovely evening. The class of 2023, the 69th graduating class of Cheshire High School, has been suffering from a serious illness over the past few months, or for some, the past few years. The disease, which commonly afflicts graduating students, has only one known cure: graduation. Yes, in mere 2 hours, we will be free of our senioritis. But before we disperse one final time to our friends, families, and prepare for parties and vacations celebrating our many accomplishments, I think it's important to look back on some of the trials and tribulations we've overcome to get here, because I would be remiss in saying that the journey was easy. As I was putting together my remarks, I stumbled upon an idea known as Murphy's Law. Now don't worry, this isn't some obscure physics concept or complicated formula. Originating from the words of an Air Force captain in 1949, as he cursed out faulty mechanics, Murphy's Law goes something like this: if something can go wrong, it likely will go wrong. Looking back on the last 4 years at Cheshire High, at the numerous hurdles that we as a class have collectively hurdled, one event in particular seems to epitomize Murphy's Law. Yes, you can probably tell what I'm talking about. And as a side note, I did write this before I learned that graduation would be indoors. I still remember where I was when I found out we were getting booted online, casually shooting hoops with Andy Norcross when his mom came out to tell us the news. I can still feel the surreal nature of the fact that we were not going to have an end to our freshman year, at least in person. It only just hit me that we are the last graduating class to have experienced the isolating transition online while in high school. Yes, in some sense, it seems like a few things that could have gone wrong did go wrong. But luckily, sitting here, 4 years later, I can say we've made it. If there's anything that I hope that you take away from this, it's not that we can prepare for every situation. Oftentimes, throughout our lives, things that can go wrong will go wrong. But I'd like to present you with a new interpretation of Murphy's Law. Given enough time, anything that needs to happen will happen. If you need to graduate, you just might graduate. At CHS, amidst COVID, SATs, APs, college apps, and exhausting nights, friendships have been born, identities shaped, and futures formed. The times that we've shared as Rams will never go away, and the lessons will stick with us for life. As we enter new chapters, I think we'll find that there are always storms to weather, and there are always rainbows to appreciate. I think I see Ani, Grace, and Shavika falling asleep as I talk, so I'll wrap it up. I think there are a few thank yous in order. Thank you to my God and my parents, who have crossed an ocean for my education, and who have been behind me for the past 18 years. To my brothers, Dan and Andy, and my sister, Emily, who are always there to motivate me and inspire me, your encouragement means the world. A special thanks to my aunts, uncles, and cousins, and the rest of my family, who are always there to support me behind the scenes, whether I see it or not. Finally, thank you to those who at CHS who have made it the place that we have come to know and love for the past 4 years. To the teachers, too numerous to name and too dedicated to describe, your impact is immense. I cannot express my gratitude to the phenomenal administration and school counseling department, as well as my school counselor, all of whom have seen me so many times that we're practically on a first name basis. Finally, thank you to the class of 2023 for shaping me and pushing each other. As an esteemed lyricist, Taylor Swift, once said, "Long live all the mountains we moved. I had the time of my life fighting dragons with you all." I know we're going to be doing big things soon, but in the meantime, congratulations.
It is my honor to present to you Andrew Zhu, the valedictorian for the Cheshire High School class of 2023. Yeah. I ask Andrew's parents to rise and be recognized. Andrew, congratulations.
Good evening, everyone, and thank you, Dr. Gadd, for the introduction. I'm Andrew, and it's an honor to be here with you all today. Standing here in front of so many classmates that I've known for what seems like forever, it's hard to believe that we are on the brink of adulthood. It feels like just yesterday that we still had the luxuries of nap time, snack breaks, or recess. But most importantly, we have the naive optimism and hope that only children possess. We persisted through 4 years of high school, through countless nights where we were only able to start homework after getting back from a late practice, counting the hours of sleep we'd get on one hand. On top of it all, we were always focusing on what seemed to be the next big thing, especially these past few months. It's easy to have lost that sense of optimism and endless joy we had when we were young. It's almost like we sacrificed our inner child by focusing on the responsibilities that come with being an adult, like choosing a college or finding a job. With the help of many, many others, though, we persevered through it. I'd like to thank some of those people today. To our teachers, who tirelessly push us to grow as students while putting up with our stupid questions like, wait, we had homework? Or can we get a mass break again? Thank you. Whoever said there's no such thing as a stupid question has never met us, but you guys still manage to deal with us every single day. To our administrators, school counselors, support staff, hall monitors, lunch staff, janitorial staff, and everyone else who does so much work to let us be able to take our high school experience for granted, thank you. To our friends and family, thank you for somehow managing to tolerate us for this long. We can be pretty difficult to deal with sometimes, whether it's never getting back over curfew, our unpredictable mood swings, or our inability to admit when we're wrong, which is never. In all seriousness, though, without your unconditional support through all the highs and lows, we definitely wouldn't be here today. Now, for some personal thank yous. To my family, especially my mom, my dad, and my brother, thank you for being there for me since day one, always supporting me, encouraging me, and not letting me give up when things got hard. And to the baseball team, cross-country team, chorus program, and the countless other Cheshire communities that have become an integral part of my life over the past 4 years, thank you. I'm sure each of you have countless people that you will be thanking today. They've all contributed to you getting to where you are now. But don't forget that the main reason you're here today is yourself. You were able to make it this far. Shocker, I know. But seriously, take a moment and give yourself a pat on the back, because this is just the beginning. As long as you continue to believe in yourself, take care of yourself, and work hard, there will be great things on the horizon for each and every one of you. As our high school experience draws to an end and we prepare to move on to big things in our future, I encourage everyone here to reflect on the past, on your inner child. Many people give the word childish a negative connotation. They think it's not a quality responsible adults should possess. Me personally, I think they're wrong. I think that everyone's childish quality, your inner child, is exactly what the world needs. I'm not talking about nap time, although that wouldn't hurt. I mean things like the bubbling excitement towards every single new thing you see and experience, or having the memory of a goldfish, forgetting about something bad as soon as the next good thing comes along. Or most importantly, the quality to continue to try, despite constant failure, until you finally succeed. Evidently, you did succeed. The fact that you're here today proves that. So the next time you get called childish, take it as a compliment. Being childish means that you have what it takes to conquer the real world. Through everything. Through an indoor promotion 4 years ago when we had an outside graduation, through COVID, through not being able to go on the senior walk on our last day of classes or for our senior fun day, and now through an indoor graduation when promotion was outside this morning, we have been through it all. But we finally reached the finish line. If karma's real, we're gonna be some pretty damn lucky people. Congratulations, class of 2023. We did it. And if you didn't care to listen to me at all, which is totally understandable, given that most of you have been looking at my backside the entire time, at least listen to the wise words of Snoop Dogg. You've always got to go back in time if you want to move forward. So as we embark on this new chapter in our lives, please don't forget to bring your inner child along for the ride. Never stop exploring, trying time after time, laughing at silly jokes, and finding joy in the simplest things. Most importantly, as you begin to change the world in your own way, remember to have some fun. It's been a pleasure, Cheshire High. Thank you, and peace out.
It gives me great pleasure to introduce this year's commencement speaker, Megan Rossi.
Thank you all for being here on this important day. I want you to take a moment to look around you. In this singular auditorium, not one single person has the same story. There is no one like you, and that's what makes you so special. Here I am, standing at our final destination, and I realize that what mattered all along was the journey and who we have become along the way. I want to thank each of our support systems that have contributed to the success of our 2023 graduates. Thank you, teachers, CHS administrators and faculty, parents, siblings, friends, and families. We wouldn't be here today without you, and we greatly appreciate all your encouragement and support to make this day possible, and not just today, but the numerous moments that have led up to this day. Character is often built during challenging times. When we think of dirt, we think of it being gross, messy, and we want to avoid it so it doesn't ruin our clothes. However, we have to go through the dirt in order to move forward. That dirt is also necessary for our beautiful trees to grow. It's their foundation. Similarly, we must experience the unwanted challenges that are messy because they provide a basis for growth. From freshman year to now, you have all grown enormously. We can't have change when we stay comfortable. I bet some of you never thought you would be here today and make it this far, but you did. What seems impossible is very much possible. Failure is often given a negative connotation, but it shouldn't be. Failure can be glorious if we look at it that way. Your failures don't define you. Rather, they shape you. You can't have growth and improvement without failure. The only time you truly fail is when you stop picking yourself back up and you stop trying. Sometimes the things that didn't work out for us actually did truly work out. No matter who you are in this auditorium, gym, or sitting home and watching this on the live stream, you have to remember to go out there and tell your story. Because your story is one that no one else in this world can tell. Your story will inspire someone else. Every person here has a purpose, and if you didn't have a purpose, well then, you wouldn't be here today. We each have our own unique contribution to the world. You have yet to experience the greatest moments of your life. Along with your diploma today comes an invisible pen that's given to you. You are the one who has the power to write your future. It's in your own hands and no one else's. Fear is a common feeling that we will all feel many times in life. But that moment when you're scared is the exact moment when you should jump. It's never too late. You're never too old, never too small, or too big. Boy, I would be lying if I said that being up here didn't scare me, but I took that jump. I hope that my leap can inspire each of you to do the same. I went from a shy girl who could barely say hi back to a senior speaking in front of hundreds of people. We often rewind a song and start it over when we realize we haven't been enjoying it enough. But life doesn't have that rewind button. Or if you don't have Spotify Premium. So we have to make sure to enjoy it from the start. We are saying goodbye to Cheshire High School, but knowing that it has changed us forever. We must close one door in order to allow for another one to open. What is coming is better than what has passed. Steve Harvey uses an analogy that I want to share. He tells us that our windshield is so much bigger than our rearview mirror because our future is more important than our past. We have a greater view of what's coming next. We can't move forward and drive the car if we keep looking at what's behind us. Our future may be unknown, but that's what is exciting, like when you open a McDonald's Happy Meal and you don't know what toy you will get. I want to remind you to focus on what truly makes you happy and go chase it. That dream in your head, it isn't accidental. It's there for a reason. Today, we must proudly wear our red and white to remember that we will always be Rams. Thank you all for attending our graduation ceremony, and congratulations to the class of 2023. We did it.
It is my pleasure to introduce the members of the Cheshire High School Honors Choir to sing a musical selection, Breathe.
That was beautiful. Before I begin my remarks, I'd like to recognize a few adults who are also graduating from Cheshire High School this evening. Two of our retirees could not be with us, but I'd like to recognize Mr. Ron Cizzullo, who after 39 years of teaching is retiring from his role as a music teacher. Mr. John Kuhner, our district music department chair and marching band director, is retiring after 22 years at Cheshire High School. So let's give them a round of applause. But Mr. Trafone, who is here, our athletic director, is retiring after 35 years of dedicated service to Cheshire Public Schools. Please stand and be recognized, Mr. Trafone. These transitions are always so bittersweet. Our colleagues move on to retirement. We all feel the loss, and we're saddened by the idea of not seeing them every day, but we also wish them every happiness. We always want things to go on as usual, for the sun to keep on shining as expected, but into everyone's life, a little rain must fall. Class of 2023, you know this better than anyone. Despite change and disappointment, like the storm that moved us inside, there are still things to be grateful for. Somehow, we all fit on this stage. Believe it or not, we do have air conditioning. The seats are a bit more comfortable. But of course, there are downsides to family, friends, teachers, and staff members watching from the West Gym. You're still here with us. A few walls can't really separate us. And you'll be seeing each graduate march through the West Gym and back into the auditorium with their diploma shortly. As a quick direction, please don't block any aisles so we can get the graduates back up here, or we'll be here till 10. Graduates, you are heading out of the hallowed halls of CHS, the school that has contained us all. The halls, classrooms, fields, and gyms will no longer be called home for you. Parents and families, our kids are moving on to schools out of state, the military, jobs that may carry them away from home and into their independent lives. But walls and halls, as solid as they seem, are temporary. Relationships are what last. Connections last. What you all have learned lasts. Who you are and who you are becoming is the work of a lifetime. Graduates, you hold your own future in your hands and you get to shape it into anything you want. You have the skills and knowledge to take on any challenge, and you've proven that over your 4 years at Cheshire High School, but to truly succeed, you have to believe. A quote from Henry Ford reads, "Whether you think you can or you think you can't, you're right." Attitude is absolutely everything. We can curse the rain, and we all did, but how long you let it bother you is in your power. As with any disappointment, challenge, or difficulty, how we adjust and respond determines the ease or difficulty of our path. Look at all of you on your graduation day. And in a few hours, you'll be, in a few minutes, you'll be crossing the stage, transitioning from high school senior to high school graduate. It's a big deal. And in your 4 years, you've met challenges, done what you thought you could not do, and transformed yourselves into the young adult you are. As a class, adapting to challenges is pretty much your wheelhouse. You recognize issues and act to fix them. You recognize goals and take steps to meet them. You decide you're going to win SCC championships and then break records and win 9. You decide you're going to win state championships and then go on to win 4. You decide, and together you support each other to make your dreams come true. You navigated complexities that vexed an entire world for the past 3 years, and you did so with grace, determination, humor, and compassion. I could not be more proud of you, and if my words stick with you at all, I hope it's this message. You can, and you will. Time goes quickly, and my time at speaking at this podium is nearly up, and your time to get your diploma is nearly here. Class of 2023, I have absolutely loved getting to know you, and I will sincerely miss you. As you graduate and go out into the world, make the most of every experience. Be present. Stay caring and funny. Remember your amazing records of academic and athletic achievements, and even more impressive, the countless acts of selflessness, kindness, and leadership your class has shown our school and our district. Each one of you will always be a Cheshire Ram. No separation of time or space can ever break that bond. But the time has come for you to embrace your future, to take what you've learned out into the wide open world. Envision it, believe in it. The possibilities are endless, and I believe in you. Congratulations to each and every one of you. So here comes the formal part. Ladies and gentlemen, the laws of the state of Connecticut require that I formally present the class of 2023 to the Superintendent of Schools and the Board of Education. Dr. Solon, Mr. Perugini, members of the board, I have the honor and privilege to present to you the 337 members of the Cheshire High School class of 2023 who, having successfully met the academic requirements of the state of Connecticut and the Cheshire Board of Education, are entitled to receive their diplomas. I charge the graduates to live up to the responsibilities and values inherent in these diplomas, to be good citizens, to bring reason to a too often irrational world, to bring compassion to a world too often torn by hatred, to build a bright future for themselves while being tolerant of the differences of others, to be contributors to our town, our state, our nation, and our global community. Dr. Solon, I present to you the Cheshire High School class of 2023.
Thank you, Dr. Gadd. Good evening, everyone. Thank you for that lackluster response. This is such an awesome night. I'm really thrilled to greet our families, friends, teachers, staff, administrators, and elected officials as we celebrate our students this evening. If there's a term that best reflects our Cheshire High School experience for 2023, it would be viral spread. The obvious reference would be to the pandemic, so that so dramatically impacted your academics, extracurriculars, and social life. That isn't necessarily what I was thinking, though. Challenges like a global pandemic can occasionally ignite a chain reaction that wasn't anticipated. For the CHS class of 2023, that chain reaction manifested itself into a rally for the ages. You may be familiar with the phrase, rise like a phoenix from the ashes, which stems from mythology. The story goes that there was a majestic bird, the phoenix, that resided in paradise. Over 1,000 years in paradise, the bird grew weary and sought something new. As the sun rose one morning, the bird sang such an enchanting song that the sun god stopped his path across the sky to listen. When the song ended and the sun began to travel again, sparks fell from the sky. These sparks hit the phoenix and its nest, creating a fire that ultimately killed the bird. However, the phoenix rose from the ashes days later, more beautiful and powerful than ever. Life was good as you transitioned to CHS as freshmen. Of course, that abruptly ended in the spring of that year. There were years of challenges and even suffering at points. It would have been understandable to stay down, but you rose. I've been associated with the Cheshire Public Schools since 2005, and I've never seen the success that your class has had. You've created incredible portfolio projects that reflect your global compassion and capacity for problem solving. Our theater program rivaled Broadway every day, not just Wednesday. Adam's Family humor there. And not that good, come on. And our music program overcame its own significant challenges, missing two key members of our staff for the entire year. Nevertheless, our musicians performed beautifully, as you heard here this evening, setting the tone for the rest of our student body. While all of those accomplishments were very impressive, our athletic teams were literally record-setting. In winning 9 SEC conference championships, the CHS class of 2023 had more conference championships than any school in Connecticut state history. That success was carried by the ultimate display of girl power when every single girls sports team won their league championship in the fall. That has also never occurred before. To top that off, our boys volleyball team was the state runner-up, and we won state championships in boys soccer, boys golf, girls open tennis, and boys lacrosse. In recognition of this incredible accomplishment, this first ever accomplishment, I commissioned a banner that you'll see hung across Route 10 for everyone who passes through Cheshire to see. Of course, you may have noticed it strung in front of the high school this evening. It turns out public works people have a thing about standing in bucket trucks holding wires during thunderstorms, but soon, it's coming. The class of 2023 has risen from its own proverbial ashes, and you've become better and more beautiful than ever. As graduates of Cheshire High School, having endured the trials of the past 4 years, you stand ready for any challenge. In a world that desperately needs reason, problem solvers, and well-grounded people, you are the answer to that call. I am so proud of everything you have accomplished over these past 4 years, and I eagerly look forward to seeing the positive impressions that you will leave on the world. Cheshire High School class of 2023, I sincerely wish each of you the very best of luck as you venture out into life after Cheshire High School. Thank you and congratulations. Mr. Perugini, Chairman of the Board of Education, it is my pleasure and my duty as Superintendent of Schools to certify that the student candidates before you have completed all graduation requirements as prescribed by the Cheshire Board of Education and the Connecticut State Board of Education. I present to you the Cheshire High School class of 2023.
Dr. Gadd, Dr. Solon, administrators, Dr. Solon's awesome team, parents, loved ones, the incredible support staff at Cheshire Public Schools, and of course our class of 2023, congratulations on this. It's been quite the challenge over the last few years, to say the least. But I want to thank you all, not just our graduates and our school personnel. Oftentimes, I still don't forget this as being a parent of 2 graduates, but the parents, the loved ones, our kids' support staff that's been through all this, helping us get through this, thank you too. It was no easy feat, but here we are. I can't help but shake my head as I was sitting at work today and I saw the forecast of gale winds, possible hail, and of course, right around the time of graduation. So I reached out to Dr. Solon, and sure enough, just like any winter storm during the winter season, he's struggling with talking to a number of meteorologists, the who's who out there, giving expert advice. And I said, what are you gonna do? And he made the rational decision. It wasn't only him, a lot of folks involved. And like all the decisions he's made on winter days, right, we get the worst case scenario from our meteorologists and we move indoors or cancel school for the day. And here we are. I look outside and it's bright and sunny. Not unlike some of the winter days we had, although we went pretty much unscathed. So the point there is this team always has your best interest, always has your safety in mind. I know they struggled with today's decision, but given safety, it was a no-brainer. But thank you for your patience for being here and working through this. So, Dr. Solon, I guess it's a little bit of karma. You had a pretty much smooth winter. not worried about school days. And the last day to hit you with this. So
let's not forget forest fires.
Either. Well, I was going to bring it up too. So, you know, it's amazing what's been happening event-wise. You know, let's just forget the animosity and division in the world for a second, which, by the way, I'm confident our graduating class is going to help solve that. We have some wonderful kids here, all of them, and I look forward to seeing what you can do to help make the world more positive. I know you will. But we've had COVID, which we talked about. Earlier this year, ChatGPT was released, and if you didn't know any better, listen to the news. Yep, you thought Cyberdyne Systems was taking over just like it was in Terminator, right? The world is coming to an end. Not necessarily. We get through that, and last week, it was a smoke. And so much so that I felt like I was being slow roasted in a smoker for 3 or 4 days. And I swear I developed a smoke ring by Friday. It was amazing. But here we are. And one last obstacle is the rain. To me, this is actually pretty fun, having an intimate graduation like this. It does bring us closer together. But I'm also cognizant, I'm going to keep this short because I am the last person standing between these wonderful students and these diplomas. But the point is, thank you all. Thank you for your patience, your support. We are extremely proud. My fellow board members are here today too, and I could tell you we are excited. We love these graduations, and you inspire us as much as anybody. So thank you. That being said, members of the Cheshire High School Class of 2023, as Chairman of the Cheshire Board of Education, it is my honor to officially now recognize you as graduates of Cheshire High School with all the rights and privileges pertaining thereto. Will the senior class advisors please come forward to read the names of the 329 graduates.
Asia Terabar. Andrew Shu.
Clyde Noel D'Souza.
Megan Rebecca Rossi.
Christian Ad Leonitsky. Ajwad Afzul. Alana Akbas. Adrian Ali. Jake Matthew Ali. Macy Allen. Leah Ellie Anderson. Peter Anderson. Jalissa Lee Andrews. Ani Ruth Arunachalam. Connor Atwater. Isabel Azula. Julia Ryan Bailey. Luke Edward Bannock. Cesar Alejandro Barbo. Ryan Barberi. Natalia Barbosa. Titus Henry Barcheski. Aiden Batchelder. Madeline Begnell. Carnice Benito Jones. Hayden Bennett. Krishna Benzi. Ilea Christine Berkowitz. Siddhant Bard Waj. Kwaku Brian Biney. Mia Blaze. Jeremy Bobruff. Zoe Bobruff. William Borland. Luca Bors Baba. Jordan May Boucher. Michael Bowman. Catherine Nicole Bradley. Elizabeth Braun. Audrey Lake Bronson. Colin Brown. Caitlin Busick. Taya Bunton. Jason Savorek. Caitlin Rose Cannon. Caleb Yale Kaplan. Amber Kastner. Danielle Cassone. Isabella May Cerrito. Billy Chamberlain. Brady Ichiro Chan. The next diploma will be presented by faculty member Susan Chasen. Ryan Harris Chasen. Jonathan Chen. June Chen. Zachariah Chen. Claudia Rebecca Chung. June Chung. Jordan Chimber. Caitlin Lorraine Cienki. Marius Ciobataro. Ella Lyndon Cohen. Timothy Considine. Megan Lauren Elizabeth Coyle. Courtney Cronin. Caitlin Elizabeth Carello. Drew Matthew Daddio. Andrew D'Agostino. The next diploma will be presented by faculty member Peter Daly. Caitlin Courtney Daly. Lily Maliti Date. Taylor Brianne Davis. Teresa De Dominicis. Michael De Joseph. Clara Rose Dempsey. Anthony DiPaolo. Mallory DiPaolo. Caitlin Sitara Desmond. Stephanie Dickinson. Matt Demick. Samir Dishnika. Anthony Joseph Distante. Marco Donato. Aiden Downey. Vanessa Duby. Rachel Julie Dubois. Emily Dugay. Charles Dusick. Sarah Dwyer. Gianna Marie Esposito. Jack Falk. Salman Farid. Jamie Fasano. Blake Firo. Damir Fell. Julia Fielding. Taylor Fitzgerald. Pierce Flynn. Madeline Forlenza. Corbin Porcelius. Kenny Forsythe the Fourth. Emma Catherine Fortunato. Brad Fowler. Allie Fox. Joseph Franco. Micah Galoza. William Gaudet. Leah Maureen Gentile. Andrew Gershfeld. Maya Gessman. Monica Galley. Julianne Rose Giordano. Rachel Goldstein. Isabella Golino. Victor Gonzalez. Sam Gravel. Caitlin Gray. Colin Gravelding. Casey Gronbach. Emma Kathleen Grove. Grayson Gersey.
Isabel Guillot. Soumya Gulati.
Chase Michael Hackett. Liam Gregory Harkins. Ava Brighton Harris. The next diploma will be presented by faculty member Lisa Hartman. Caitlin Hartman. Thomas Hayden. Tyler James Hayden. Emery Hendon. The next diploma will be presented by faculty member Amy Russell. Michael Herskovici. Sydney Alexandra Hidalgo. Peyton Hilson. Sean Parker Horton. Ildi Hoxa.
Catherine Huang. Austin Yu.
Julia Hummel. Elise Doyle Hurlburt. Anna Monica Hurlbut. Emma Schuyler Ingerson. Noah Ingiani. Madeline Grace Anemo.
Matthew E. Irizarry.
Jake Evan Isaacson. Matthew Jockler. Valentina Jerez. Evan P. Joachim. Gabrielle Helene Johnson. Tristan Johnson. Sophia Alexandra Johnston. Ayana Jones. Kyla Madison Kemp. Elizabeth Catherine Clem. David Coe. Tyler Koshal. Shavika Kumar. Charles Edward Kurtz III. Haley LaCroix. Paola Larios. Aiden Lark.
The next diploma will be presented by faculty member Julia Lawler, Audrey Lawler. Jack Leary. Allison Layton. Noah Levine. Vincent Lin. Vicky Liu. Kayla Marie Lundquist. The next diploma will be presented by faculty member Brian Lopez. Helene Lopez. The next diploma will be presented by faculty member Stacy Lopez. Ty Lopez. William Lovelace. Alexandra Lucas. Emma Lucina. Dennis Lulo. Gabe Magriz. Anish Mandava. Jeremiah Tiger Mann. Malukin David Marchand. Jack McCarrion. Judith Grace Markella. Marissa Marie Markowski. Alexis Martin. Ava Kate Matatowski. Hannah Mayer. Miles Mayer. Catherine Rose McCardle. Aiden McCauley. Alexa McPadden. Isabella Mehta. Andrew Milano. Elizabeth Ann Miller. Aaron Miller. Jason Miller. Kayla Mingo. Autumn Rain Mitchell. Avery Mola. Haley Mola. Jordy Monrell. Vellante Moore. Connor John Moran. Samantha Mudry. Julia Mirko. Elijah James Murphy. Ryan Murphy. Connor Brendan Nash. Maxwell Christopher Nemec. Trevor Nielsen. Andrew Norcross. Aaron Northway. Elena O'Donnell. Christopher O'Neill Jr. Rocco Anthony Ocone Krause. Alana O'Donnell. Loren Open. Sarah Orlinsky. Alexandra Nicole Palladino. Catherine Eileen Palma. Charlotte Irene Palma. Daniel Parent. Unsa Park. Colby Paul. Amelia Perlini. Lauren Piranese. Ryan Piccarello. Anna Pochu. Caitlin Grace Post. Avery Petralla. Violet Putnam. Ryan Rajan. Gigi Ronaldo. Carly Rashi. Ireland Richard. Caitlin Rivera. Emily Rivera. Joshua A. Rivera. Marissa Leah Rivera. Martin Roberg. Patrick Roberg. Brett David Prince Ratchford. Noah Rockoff. Emily Roden. Joshua Rodriguez. Lily Rozier. Justin Rua. Alyssa Russo. Mariana Sanmaniego. Lauren Samela. Jacob Josue Santa Cruz. Lucas Sargolini. Zachary Schnitzer. Will C. Rolls. Haley Shaw. Madison Shaw. Audrey Ray Sheehan. Devin Sheehan. Valerie Schlick. Ava Marie Simeon. Michael Pasquale Simeon. Christina Elizabeth Cherois. Kira Smith. Rome Anthony Smith. Star Snyder Drysdale. Liana Marie Solisi. Margaret Ann Sola. Kayla Sotero. Carissa Spring. Vanessa Squalenti. Matthew Joseph Smedberg. Sagarika Srinivasan. Dylan Stanowski. Nev Sandra Stanziel. Yulena Stevenson. Benjamin Miller Strout. Kevi Sulalari. Sophia Serrato. Christian Matthew Sutton. Paige Sutelli. Julia Swartz. Ima Tilipan Beneno. Hannah Tao. John Robert Tarka. Luca Tamel. Benjamin Thompson. Gabriella Tirado. Lazaro Antonio Torres. Blake Tripodina. Luigina Toriano. Dylan Tu. Juliana Tyler. Taryn Ugrin. Catherine Elise Ulicki. Andrew Bruce Fats. Andrew Vail. Kylie Juliana Vasquez. Arjun Vedery. Caroline Veliber. Veronica Verbitsky. Sophia Villarreal. Felicia Fong. Catherine Fong. Anthony David Vado. Erica Weibel. Caleb Walenziak. Charlie Wallenstein. Samantha Wang. Silas Wang. Hannah Warzika. Lila Ann Watkinson. Jack Riley Watson. Lily Watson. Gavin Alexander Werner. Riley Whalen. Luke Weedman. Alyssa Wilkinson. Carolyn Tanka Wilson. Riley Wilson. Michaela Wright. Michael Joseph Wynn. Kaylee Shia. Grace Sophia Zhu. Sophie Yale. David Yihanera. Hannah Young. Clinta Isuf Zayaku. Catherine Alice Zera. Jake Zawal. Tamara Zenzola. Sianna Sogai.
We have a few graduates still funneling back from going through the West Gym, so we're going to give them just a minute, but let's give a little hoot and holler for the kids in here. So while they're filing back, I have a few last instructions for our graduates. I'm waiting. Come on. We're just going to pause a bit. So the end and exiting a venue like this is always a little complex. So once we congratulate our graduates when they're all back on the stage, they are going to recess, all of us on the stage are going to recess by going up these two aisles. Then we're going to head into the West Gym, and then please join us there. But if you could let us get out of the auditorium, we promise we'll move. And then we can greet everyone in the West Gym and outside, okay? Now outside, right? I think we just have a few more. We're done. Okay. So our graduates are finding their way back to their seats, and I'm going to need all of you to stand and then not do anything. I know, right? Sounds crazy. But would the graduates please stand? It is a long-standing, no pun intended, academic tradition that those who have been presented their diplomas may signify this achievement, don't do it yet, by moving their tassels from right to left. Okay, now. Congratulations to the class of 2023. Woo! Will the flag bearers please come and get the flags? And we're going to remove the colors from the platform. And before we begin the recessional, our faculty is going to line up outside, and they will join you. Thank you. Congratulations to our students, and thank you again for coming.
closing time. Open all the doors and let you out into the world. Closing time. Turn all of the lights on over every boy and every girl. Closing time. One last call for alcohol, so finish your whiskey or beer. Closing time. You don't have to go home, but you can't stay here. I know who I want to take me home.